Hello and welcome to FYI. I'm Gargi Rawat. Today on the show, we're going to be talking about monoclonal antibodies as a treatment for coronavirus. Is it going to be a game changer, as many have predicted? Now, the Indian regulatory body, Central Drug Standards Control Organization, has recently approved a cocktail of two antibodies, Casirivimab and Imdevimab, for restricted emergency use to treat mild to moderate COVID in adults and pediatric patients. These are laboratory-made proteins that mimic the immune system's ability to fight off harmful pathogens such as viruses. Monoclonal antibodies therapy became very famous last year when it was used to treat the then US President Donald Trump. Now, so far, according to reports, clinical trial data suggests that the drug can reduce the risk of hospitalization and mortality by 70%. So, well, to talk more about this, we're now joined by the doctors who are going to explain exactly what this treatment is and whether it is as promising as it's made out to be. We're joined by Dr. Dhruv Chaudhary, Professor and Chair, Pulmonary and Critical Care Medicine at the Medical College, Rohtak. Thank you so much, Dr. Chaudhary, for joining us.
First and foremost, what
do you have to say about this treatment? We've been hearing about it, ever since Trump was also treated with it. I remember when COVID first began a few months in, when I was speaking to many experts and doctors around the world at that time as well, they spoke about this promising treatment that was being developed and researched. This was before, of course, we had the vaccines. But what is your view of it?
You see, this is a basic... If you really ask me, is a cocktail of antibodies which have been there, and it's like a passive immunization which you have been practicing early. So they are sort of a drugs which can block the antivirus into the cells. It can also reduce the incidence or severity of the disease. So probably I think it's a great advance which have taken place. And what we are doing is that if you see the normal immunity depends upon the antibodies. Now, what we are doing right now is by creating that molecule in the lab, we are now giving a certain amount of drug to the patient, which we think can neutralize it, and thereby it can prevent its affecting other cells, and it can kill the virus there. So it works two ways. One, it doesn't allow it to reproduce and do it. And secondly, which are there, they will be neutralized. So it can prevent the disease, and those who has mild to moderate, then it can be sorted.
Right. One of the reports is also that it's very expensive. It's costing around 1 lakh for a dosage. What can you tell us about that? And isn't that prohibitive for most of India?
You see, in the USA, it is costing somewhere around $1,100 to $1,300. And why I'm saying so, we have used it in a couple of patients in India, our context. They have been used in Gurgaon in 4 to 5 cases, and which I have a personal knowledge of. And I think, yes, you are right, that is expensive. But if I convert it into it, it will be around 50,000 or it should be around 55,000 rupees, which is a big money. But at the same time, if I can prevent, especially people who are at a high risk of hospitalization, so probably it will be effective and it will be cost effective. That's what I mean. But I want to also share with you something interesting. The Roche has donated 10,000 of these molecules or these doses to Government of India. In Haryana, we have also received around about 600, which is as a part of the donation, which we shall be using in our patients. And through the government, which we will be using, they will be free of cost. So probably we will be try to see to it that the patient who can't afford are taken care of. And if everything goes well, from Monday, we will be starting using.
All right. We're also joined by Dr. Shashank Joshi, a member of the COVID Task Force, Maharashtra. Sir, we were just discussing about the monoclonal antibodies, the therapy, and how promising it is. What can you tell us about this? Also, when can we expect it to be available in India?
So I think it's a very promising early use agent. The key of this monoclonal antibody or lytic cocktail is it has to be used in the first 3 days. Its best efficacy and all the data published is in the first 72 hours, but it can be used up to 7 days of therapy, and it should not be used in people who need oxygen. So it has some very robust data, and it is recommended by the US National Institute of Health, which is equivalent of ICMR there. And it can clearly save hospitalizations in the high risk category, and it saves hospitalization in more than 70% cases. So it is a wonderful welcome armamentarium, and this is one thing which we know for certain beyond reasonable doubt that it works. Of course, it comes at a cost, but the cost of hospitalization is far more than the cost of actually the medication itself. And the drug which is used in India is in one vial, you can use it for two patients. So that is other advantage. And it should be available by Monday or Tuesday. We are expecting the stocks to be available in Mumbai by Monday or Tuesday, and then it will be used. And it can be used in an emergency room. It can also be given IV or subcutaneously both. So either or can be given, but preferably it is given in a hospital setup, and then the patient can go back home and remains digitally connected to the healthcare provider.
Well, it's very, very costly, 1 lakh for a dose, but also you have to go to a hospital for it to be administered, and this is seen to be a bit of a drawback about this drug.
Can be given subcutaneously, but, and I think the cost will come out to around 50,000-60,000 rupees. I don't think it will come out to be around 1 lakh rupees.
Well it's not available yet, but that's what we're hearing from hospitals when we checked with them about how much it would cost. They said it's possibly around 1 lakh. Yes, that's not a sure thing, but yes, go ahead.
That is for the vial. And the vial may, you can use it for two patients, and therefore it will come to around 50,000.
Gargi, exactly the same what Dr. Shashank is saying, I'm adding it up, because I have a personal experience and knowledge. It has cost around 1,100 to 1,300 US dollars when it was imported. And now instead of 0.4, we are using 1.2 gram dose, which Dr. Shashank is talking of. So I don't expect that it should not be going beyond 50,000-55,000, but still, all said and done, it's a big money for a large number of people.
All right. We also are joined by Dr. Subramaniam Swaminathan, a Director Infectious Diseases and Infection Control, Gleneagles Global Group in Chennai. And also Dr. Vasant Nagvekar, Infectious Disease Specialist, Leelavati Hospital and Research Center. Thank you so much, doctors, for joining us. Dr. Swaminathan, your view on monoclonal antibodies. You know, it's coming at a time when we've been let down by so many other treatments as well. You know, plasma therapy, of course, totally disregarded. Remdesivir recently removed by the WHO. Now this treatment that we've been hearing about since, you know, Trump was treated with it, and even before that, I was just talking earlier about how earlier as well I'd heard from experts about it. So your view on this treatment and how promising it is?
See, it's not new in that we have similar things to compare it with.
But it's coming to India.
Correct, but we have other things which are comparable. Rabies immunoglobulin for that matter, or tetanus immunoglobulin for that matter. We have immunoglobulins which are used for other diseases after being infected, which is very effective. It's just that the way this is being made is, and the way it's being used is a little different. So I don't think people should be afraid of the monoclonal antibody per se. It's just a paradigm shift in the way we do it. It's amazing. Yes, cost is going to be high. But you know, when we started having computers, they were insanely expensive. But today, look at the cost of it. It will come down with time. And I think it's a good thing to start with, because I don't want it becoming abused across the counter for all kinds of irrational indications. And if we can scale it up and use it in a rational way, we can ensure that the right person gets it at the right time without abuse.
Right, that we keep hearing about, it's supposed to be given at a very particular time and for very particular patients. Dr. Nagvekar, if you could come in here, tell us more about, you know, how this is only to be used in certain type of patients and at the right time.
I think, can you hear me?
Yes, go ahead.
Okay, so I think I would place this drug as, you know, if anybody is having a fever of more than 101 persisting beyond 72 hours, because majority of the fever, I think 85% of the people would defervesce their fever within first 72 hours. So I would reserve this drug for people who have persistent fever beyond 72 hours. And I think these are, and of course, it is available, will be available in IV as well as subcut. So I would give it anybody who is having more than 100 or 101 fever beyond 72 hours as an anti, you know, as a drug to take care of the COVID-19.
And do you think it's going to be a game changer like it's being projected? The numbers, of course, the claims are very high that it can prevent, you know, hospitalization by 70% is what some of the studies say. This is clinical data, trial data, of course.
Yeah, definitely. I think if it is priced properly, and if the pricing is, you know, very close to what people can afford, definitely it would be a game changer. And I think the studies have shown that yes, definitely it prevents the hospitalization by more than 71%. And we are looking forward for this. But the most important thing is the pricing of the drug. That would be very important so that people can afford, and then only then it will be useful. if it's going to be very expensive, then I think it will not be people's pocket, you know, to buy
right,
this drug.
Absolutely,
but yes, it would be a game changer.
When we were researching for this show, we were told it could cost up to 1 lakh for a dose. Now, Shashank Joshi is saying that it's going to be less than that, around 50, 60, and that can be used for 2 patients. But even that is high. But of course, if you compare with being hospitalized, then it perhaps does work out better. Dr. Joshi, tell us, where all is this treatment being used? We have heard about the United States. Where else is it being used in the world?
In many geographies across the world, it is a standard of care. And in the US, I think it has been almost used for less than a year. And it is approved in various parts of US. Some parts of Europe are using it. Some parts of Middle East are using it. It is also used in Singapore and some parts of Asia. So it is not something which is unusual. It is used. And it is, as Dr. Swaminathan said very clearly, that this is something which has been known, that this is an immunoglobulin, and we have been using it appropriately in appropriate cases. So I think, you know, it gives us a window of treatment in high-risk individuals in the first 3 days. And that's the right time to use it. And I think it can save hospitalization, at least in the high-risk cases. And the data is very compelling. See, most of COVID data is very poor and scant. This is one therapy where the data is compelling and the evidence base is very high. NIH rarely recommends on their panel a drug. Either they will say they can't comment, or they say it should not be used. But this is one therapy where they said that this can be used. And therefore, that is something which is useful. The key, as I said, is going to be early use. And early use, best data, published data is less than 72 hours. Vasant said that if it is fever or not coming down for 3 days, is a clinical marker. But probably I would use it much earlier as well. Because if you have a window of intervention in a high-risk category, like uncontrolled diabetic, uncontrolled hypertension, somebody's obese, somebody has chronic kidney failure, I have an opportunity to intervene early so that person doesn't land up in the hospital, because the cost of hospitalization can run in lakhs, and that's something which we can do if we appropriately treat the individuals. So it is something as an approach which used to say 20 years back, hit hard, hit early. And this is a drug which hits hard, if hit early, can give some proper evidence-based results.
Right, and it can be used in young patients as well. I was reading for pediatric patients above 40 kilos is what has been said.
That's correct.
All right, Dr. Swaminathan, any concerns that you have about this drug as and when it will become available? And, you know, we don't know right now how widely it will be available when it first hits the market.
I think that's going to be the concern, because I don't think we're going to have enough doses to go around, because I don't know if they can even project for the number of doses that will be required. See, like Dr. Joshi put it, see, I have cancer patients, I have transplant patients, I have patients whose immune system is not good. In these patients, I cannot rely on vaccination because it may not take as well. And for them, this represents a way of hope. So for me, I have vulnerable patients for whom vaccine is not necessarily the only answer, and they need more than that. And I think this is going to be a valuable part of it. And to me, the Achilles heel is going to be 2 things. One, we have to rework our education of patients. Because we've been telling them now, stay home for the first 4-5 days and then come in for evaluation if you still have symptoms. Now we have to rechange that and say, come in early. Come in on day one, come in on day two, get your testing done, and if you have COVID, you start treatment. So that has to be educated both for the medical fraternity and also to the patient. And the second thing is ensuring that it's being given to the right patient at the right time, not to patients who are already sick and things like that. And the third thing is availability. I think this is going to be a key issue. I don't think we can even project how much we need. I think within the first 2 weeks, we'll have an idea as to what the need is and how much we need to get into the country.
Right. Dr. Chaudhary, your concerns on that front, on availability and, you know, also telling doctors more about it. I mean, one of the issues has been, you know, abuse of certain treatments of COVID, for COVID, like steroids. I think we've spoken extensively on over the last couple of weeks about overuse of it. But this treatment also, again, doctors will have to learn about it, exactly when is the right time to intervene, when is the right time to use it, how it can't be used just for about everybody.
I think you are right. I would like to keep it reserved for the people who primarily have a high risk of progression to a severe disease, as have been told by Dr. Shashank Joshi and Dr. Swaminathan. I think that will be the area. But again, I will re-emphasize this, that we need to do a testing early. This is for the confirmed case. It is not for a suspect case. Therefore, we need to have an RT-PCR positivity one. Secondly, need to be used early. Though the manufacturer says can be used up to 10 days, provided there is no antibodies in the body. I think that is the third important component which we need to look at. Therefore, I have no issues in it. We already are trying to get people diagnosed early. In my state, now the average time of getting a diagnosis is third day. I think that's a good enough for it. The only thing we have to ensure is that the labs give us result within preferably 24 hours. Because the lab result taking is taking longer time at certain places if the load is high. But now things are going up, so it's there. But again, people should remember it is not a wonder drug for everybody. Mild, moderate, don't need it if you don't have a risk factor. So therefore, we have to use in appropriate setting. As far as an early use is concerned, I'm telling you that already the government has got 10,000 doses, Government of India from WASH. So they have been all distributed to the different states. So my state itself, so we are in a position now straight away to use this from Monday, because that is already to be there. And we are disseminated now practically to the whole state. So we should be able to use it quickly, as far as I can say about Haryana is concerned. I don't know about Maharashtra or Karnataka or Tamil Nadu,
right,
but I assure you, we will be doing it in our state soon. But at the same time, how quickly free in the open market it is there to see. My request to the people is, for God's sake, don't put it. I am realizing the people who have the money, keeping remdesivir, tocilizumab at their home. Now, that is not to be done.
All right, Dr. Nagvekar, this will require patients, as we've been discussing, to come in earlier for the treatment with monoclonal antibodies. Also, concerns about it's not as easy to administer, is it? There is some complication there in the sense you will possibly have to come to the hospital for the administration.
Yeah, that's right. I think as of now, all the patients who will be requiring or who will be eligible for this monoclonal antibody will be definitely hospitalized or at least observed for at least 6 to 8 hours. That means one day hospitalization will be the must. And even after the giving the dose, very, very important is that these patients require to be monitored for next 3 to 5 days as how they are behaving. Because if you see that, it prevents 70% of the hospitalization, but people should not take it for granted or should not have a false sense of security that this, I've taken it, means it's done. We have to see, we have very important, whichever hospital does it, they have to follow up that patient, or the patient has to give a report or report to the doctor, or the doctors have to follow them for next 3 to 5 days that they don't have a false sense of security. It's the same protocol that is monitoring the temperature, monitoring the saturations, doing a 6-minute walk test. All this will be continued even after you take this monoclonal antibody and go home. So that will be very, very important. And second thing is, though this drug was tested on one risk factor, the study which was done, but if you see the second wave which has hit India, it has not bothered about the risk factors at all. It has not bothered about the gender also. So whether it's a male or a female, it has not bothered the second wave and the mutant virus. It has not bothered whether the patient, in fact, majority of the people who are getting admitted are not having any risk factors, and they are between 20 and 50 years of age. So I think compared to the Western population, our population is completely different. So I think our population may be eligible without a risk factor. It would be the severity of the fever and the duration that people should be quickly coming and taking this dose. But most important, follow-up of the patient would be the most crucial, that is very important, and not have a false sense of security.
All right, very important points there, and we're going to slip into a short break. We're discussing monoclonal antibodies as a treatment for coronavirus. It's going to be available in India Monday onwards, and looking into the pros and cons. And also on the other side of the break, we're going to discuss one issue that you just talked upon, Dr. Nagvekar, is about variants and how effective this treatment is against variants. Stay with us.